When we're first learning about any topic, the examples used to first illustrate the principles often seem contrived and unrealistic. This may seem especially true for electrical circuits when we think about the immense complexity of modern electronics. Though doubtless on one level this is true, on the whole it is not. Through the theories developed by pioneers in electrical engineering like Ohm, Kirchhoff, Thevenin, and many others, we've learned that much of a circuit's behavior can be analyzed by looking at portions or models of circuits. This allows us to apply simplified analyses to many circuits. Today, we'll continue to learn about some of those techniques that we can apply to simple or simplified circuits. In the last couple of videos, we covered the definitions of series and parallel and went over how those definitions could be used to simplify resistor networks. Now we'll look at another application of series and parallel as it applies to circuit analysis. If we take a look at a simple series circuit with a 10-volt source, with a 3-ohm resistor and a 7-ohm resistor in series, we could combine the 3-ohm and the 7-ohm resistor into an equivalent resistance of 10 ohms. Then we could find the current from the source by dividing the source voltage by the equivalent resistance seen by the source, and we find the current is 1 amp. If we wanted to determine the voltage across, say, this 7-ohm resistor by Ohm's law, the voltage across the 7-ohm resistor is that current of 1 amp times 7 ohms, which results in 7 volts. While that was a simple analysis, we might be able to apply this more broadly by recognizing a pattern. Let's start with a general series circuit consisting of an arbitrary voltage source and two resistors, R1 and R2. If we wanted to know the voltage across R2, we could start by determining the current from the source, and it is the source voltage divided by the equivalent resistance. If this current is known, we could find the voltage we're interested in by multiplying that current by the resistance associated with the voltage. Combining these two equations, we find the voltage we're looking for is the resistance associated with the voltage we're looking for divided by the equivalent resistance times the source voltage. If we try to do the same thing with a similar circuit that has three resistors, let's say we wanted to know the voltage across V1. The current from the source is the voltage of the source divided by the sum of resistors. The voltage V1 would then be that current times R1. Combining these equations, we come up with a similar result. The voltage we're trying to determine is the resistance associated with the voltage divided by the equivalent resistance times the source voltage. When we know the voltage across a series of resistors, we can determine the voltage of any individual resistors by multiplying the resistance we're interested in divided by the equivalent resistance of all known resistors in series times that known voltage. This will be true no matter how many resistors there are. That's because series resistors all have the same current through them. That current will always be the voltage across the series combination divided by the sum of resistors. And the voltage is always equal to that current times the resistance. So the voltage across any resistor, say Rn, is the resistor in question divided by the equivalent resistance of the series combination times the voltage seen by that series combination. This principle is called voltage division. Let's apply this to a horribly contrived example, but at least it's one with numbers. Let's look at the following circuit. Here we have a circuit with several resistors in it, some of which are in series with each other. Let's say, for some reason, we know the voltage between these two nodes. I've highlighted the nodes in blue and green in hopes that it'll be easier to see where that 15 volts exists. Clear that the 15 volts is across the 3 kiloohm resistor. That's also across the series combination to the right. I'm going to choose the voltage across the 4 kiloohm resistor as the one we're looking for. Then by what we've just developed, the voltage across the 4 kiloohm resistor will be 4 kiloohms divided by the sum of resistors in series times 15 volts. Performing some calculations, we can find the voltage across the 4 kiloohm resistor is 2 volts. Voltage division will work any time we know the voltage across a series of resistors. We could even work backward. If we knew the voltage across a particular resistor in a series combination, we could determine the voltage that's across the entire combination. Or if we happen to know both voltages and most of the resistors, we could use this to determine an unknown resistance in series. We should verify this in the laboratory. Things that are in series have the same current through them. With series resistors and a known voltage, we've developed something called voltage division. How about parallel elements? What do we know about them? They have the same voltage across them. But there's a similar principle that applies to parallel conductances and a known current going into the combination. Let's look at an arbitrary current source connected in parallel with two parallel conductances. We need a reminder, conductance is a reciprocal of resistance. We can write Ohm's law in terms of conductances as voltage times conductance equals current. We only have two nodes in this circuit, so we only have one voltage. I'll call it Vs. Using Ohm's law and the concept of equivalent conductance, the voltage in the circuit will be the source current divided by the equivalent conductance. So we have Vs equals Is divided by the quantity G1 plus G2. If we wanted to know a particular current through a conductance, we could use Ohm's law to determine that current is equal to the conductance times the voltage. Combining these two equations, we have G1 divided by the quantity G1 plus G2 times the source current is equal to the current through the conductor, G1. It is pretty straightforward to extend this to any number of conductances in parallel. Let's assume we have n conductances in parallel, all supplied by a current source, Is. If we want to know the current through the nth conductance, all we need to know is the voltage across it. Let's call that Vs. The voltage will be the current from the source divided by the equivalent conductance of all the conductors in parallel. Since we know the parallel conductances add, we're in business. The voltage will be the supply current divided by the sum of conductances. Since we know that the current through the nth conductance will be that conductance times the voltage across it, we can combine these equations to write the general solution. If we have parallel conductances, the current through any particular conductance will be the conductance we're interested in, divided by the sum of conductances in parallel times the current supplied to the combination. How would this work with a real circuit? Starting with a semi-arbitrary circuit, let me start by giving a circuit in terms of resistances. Let's say we know that we have 6 milliamps being supplied through a 7 kilo ohm resistor to our parallel resistors. The first thing I'm going to do with this circuit is redefine the resistances as conductances. This doesn't change anything but our perspective, and it works for any number of conductances in parallel, so in the end it will be easier. Conductance is simply the reciprocal of resistance, so I'll write that for each of them. The 6 milliamps still enters the combination. The 7 kilo ohm resistor does not affect the current, so it doesn't change anything we're looking for. Let's skip it. This leaves us with three conductances. Where the 5 kilo ohm resistor was, we have a 0.2 millisiemens conductance. Where the 2 kilo ohm resistor was, we have a 0.5 millisiemens conductance. And where the 20 kilo ohm resistor was, we have a 0.05 millisiemens conductance. We can then write the current as I2 equals the conductance we're interested in, divided by the sum of conductances times the current entering the parallel combination. We can simplify this to 0.5 millisiemens divided by 0.75 millisiemens times 6 milliamps. The final result is we have 4 milliamps through the conductance or resistance in question. In this case, the 2 kilo ohm resistor. So there we have it, voltage and current division. For voltage division, we need to have series resistors with a known voltage across the combination. Then the voltage across an individual resistor will be that resistance divided by the sum of resistors in series times that known voltage. For current division, we need to have parallel conductances with a known current through the combination. Then the current through the individual conductance will be that conductance divided by the sum of conductance in parallel times the known current. You may be thinking to yourself, great, but how many circuits are actually that simple? Actually, many circuits are this simple, even when a circuit is not very simple. We'll learn something later that will allow us to make even complex circuits into voltage and current dividers. That doesn't come for a while yet, but the names Thevenin and Norton will come up when it does. That's all for today. Go out and make it a great one.